Skills. This is the unit 1 introduction. A presentation is the process of presenting a topic to an audience. Okay. So what is the presentation means? Who presents means, where presents means, how it is present means. A presentation is means a demonstration. Demonstration means maybe this is a one kind of machine, how this works. So the demonstration, the person who comes technician demonstrates, shows how it works, how we have to make it work. So demonstration. Introduction, lecture or speech, whatever it may be, whatever the it may be, demonstration or introduction or lecture or speech to inform. The main intention of this presentation is to inform, persuade, inspire, inform means giving information. Persuade means making the audience to understand your concern and make them agree whatever you say. Inspire, inspiration, giving inspiration, motivation, or to build goodwill, or to present a new idea or product. The term can also be used for a formal or ritualized introduction or offering, as with the presentation of a debutant. A presentation is a means of communication that can be adapted to various speaking situations. So this presentation activity method, this presentation method is used in various situations, such as talking to a group, addressing a meeting, or briefing a team, explaining the strategy or the rules to a team. Next, to be effective means to make it successful, to make the presentation successful, step by step preparation and the method and means of presenting the information should be carefully considered. Step by step information and means of presenting the information should be carefully considered. Whatever the information you want to speak, you have to select it carefully. And whatever the information you want to present, you have to prepare it carefully. Next, a presentation requires you to get a message. A presentation requires you to get a message across to the listeners and will often contain a persuasive element. It may, for example, be a talk about the positive work of your organization, what you could offer an employer, or why you should receive additional funding for a project. So if you are giving a presentation to a big company to put funds in your project, to sanction funds, to give funds to your company, to your project, you have to present it effectively. So you have to make them to give the money to your project. Next, preparing presentation. Preparing a presentation. So how to prepare a presentation? What are the elements are there in the presentation? So if you see, preparation is the single important part of making a successful presentation. So the main concept, main thing is to make the presentation successful, what you have to do, the first and best rule is preparation. Preparation is the only solution, only the way to make our presentation successful. It is a crucial foundation, and you should dedicate as much time to it as possible. Avoiding shortcuts. So you have to dedicate your time, your work. Good preparation will ensure that you have thought carefully about the messages that you want or need to communicate in your presentation, and it will also help boost your confidence. So good preparation makes you confident, and also you communicate it effectively. So steps in preparing a presentation. The main steps in preparing a presentation. Preparing a presentation can be an overwhelming experience. Preparing a presentation can be an overwhelming experience if you allow it to be one. So very important. The strategies and steps below are provided to help you break down what you might view as a large job into smaller, more manageable tasks. So below strategies, the strategies and steps are given below. By using them, that means the steps help you to make your presentation effective. Step 1. Analyze the audience. First, before giving speech or presentation or whatever it may be, first you have to analyze the audience. Who are the audience? Are they students? Are they employees? Are they uneducated? Are they educated? Are they labor? Are they officers? Whatever it may be, you have to analyze the audience. Can they understand English, Hindi, or they can only understand Telugu? Can you use English? Can you use data? Can you use some other information in the presentation? You have to analyze it. It is a good idea to obtain some information on the backgrounds. So you have to get information, background information, values and interests of your audience. Are the audience interested to listen only stories or inspiring speech or any economical data? What are their interests? You have to get the information. Then only you can give effective speech, interesting speech. You feel your speech is interesting, but what about the audience? The audience may not feel it is interesting because their interest is not this. Their interest is related to computers, but you are explaining about some other. Okay. So, second point. Select a topic before presenting. You have to select a topic. Topic is very important. Which topic you want to explain, present? If possible, select a topic that is of interest. That is of interest to the audience and to you. So the topic must be interesting to the speaker and the audience. If the speaker is not interested on the topic, he may not present that information effectively. If the audience is not interested on the topic, they may not listen. So, topic is very important. So, the audience finds relevant and more enjoyable to research a topic that is of interest to you. If you are interested on that topic, you get information, more information, and you present more information. Next, step 3 is define the objective. Define the objective of the presentation. So, what is the goal? What is the aim of this presentation? You have to define. Once you have selected a topic, write the objectives of the presentation in a single concise statement. You have to write what is the object of the statement. The objective needs to specify exactly what you want your audience to learn. So, at the end of the presentation, what is the main information the audience must learn, must get? So that is the objective. So the objective needs to specify exactly what you want your audience to learn from your presentation. Base the objective and the level of the content on the amount of time you have for the presentation and the background knowledge of the audience. So, presentation must be based on the availability of the time. How much time you have? Based on the information, based on the availability of the time, you have to present the information. Okay, next. Preparing the content of your presentation. Content means main concept, main information. How to prepare the main information? So, step 4. Prepare the body of the presentation. Prepare the body of the presentation. Main information. After defining the objective of your presentation, determine how much information you can present. How much information you can present in the amount of time allowed. In the given time, how much information you can give? Suppose the time is given to you only 10 minutes of time. How much information can you give? How much information can you talk, present to the audience? So you have to determine it. Next, use your knowledge about the audience to prepare a presentation with the right level of details. So, what kind of audience are they? It is very important. You have to keep it in your mind. Next, strategies to help you to do this include the following. So, what are the strategies to include the information? So first, present data and facts. Present data and facts. Whatever the truth is there, don't give the information that is false or opinions. Don't give opinions. Facts only. Read the quotes from experts. Suppose famous persons in that area. Suppose if it is the information you are presenting related to economics, then you have to use the famous persons, veterans in that area. Suppose Shakti Das of RBI or finance ministers, Karl Marx, whatever it may be. You have to quote their words, whatever they said about this topic. Next, provide vivid descriptions. Clear explanation is more important. Next, step 5. Prepare the introduction and conclusion. So, well in advance, you have to prepare how to start the preparation, how to start the presentation, how to close the presentation. So, introduction and closing. So, once you have prepared the body of the presentation, decide how you will begin and end that talk. How to start, how to end. You have to decide it before, while in the preparation only. Make sure the introduction captures the attention of your audience and the conclusion summarizes and reiterates your important points. So, before beginning the presentation, you have to attract the audience. You have to catch the minds of the audience. You have to get the concentration of the audience. And at the end, whatever you told, whatever you explained, you have to summarize it at the end. In other words, in the beginning, tell them what you are going to tell them. And tell them, then tell them what you told them. So, what you are going to tell in the beginning, what you have told in the ending. So, both these two things are important. Next one is how to present it. So, by reading from paper or from tablet or mobile or not speaking from memory, there are some methods. So, first one. Speaking from memory. A distinct advantage of speaking from memory is your ability to speak to the audience without relying on notes or scripts. Without depending on notes or scripts, speaking to the audience. This allows you the flexibility to move away from the podium and to maintain eye contact with the audience. So you can speak directly while watching their faces. You need not to see paper. You can see their faces. What are their expressions? Are they showing interest or not? Are they showing not interest? It's like that. So present information that is inaccurate or completely lose your brain, train of thoughts. So that main disadvantage means this method is that you will forget an important points if you don't have any points list. Sometimes you may only explain out of 5 only 3, out of 10 only 5. Sometimes you may forget some points if you speak from memory. So if you decide to deliver your presentation from memory, have notes handy to jog your memory just in case. So write the main headlines or subheadings on a paper and keep in your pocket. If you forget them suddenly, you can recall them. Next, speaking from notes. Preparing notes and speaking from it. So many people like to speak from notes. These notes are either on cards or paper or electronic tools. Using this method, you sound natural rather than rehearsed, and you can still maintain a relatively good eye contact with the audience. So you can speak, present the information while watching their faces. The disadvantage of this method is that you might not express your key ideas and thoughts as well as you may have liked had you planned your exact words in advance. Next, speaking from text. Speaking from text involves writing your speech out word for word, everything as it is, exactly, letter by letter, word by word. The advantage is that you plan in advance exactly what you are going to say and how you are going to say it. The disadvantage is that you might appear to the audience to be stiff or rehearsed. That means your presentation may not be effective. Next, using a combination methods, using the two methods, combining two methods or three methods and presenting. So you may find the best method to be a combination of all three. So combining all three is the best method according to the experts. For instance, experts suggest you memorize the first and last 10 minutes of your talk so that you can speak flawlessly and without notes. Next, presentation. Use of presentation aids effectively. Presentation aids means maybe you can say that projectors, mobiles, laptops, papers, paper cuts, paper cuttings, charts, like that. Presentation aids, sometimes also called sensory aids, are the resources beyond the speech itself that a speaker uses to enhance the message conveyed to the audience. The type of presentation aids that speakers most typically make use of are visual aids. So the main point here is, what are the main visual aids? Means visual aids, that means pictures, diagrams, charts and graphs. Audio speech excerpts, that means pieces, parts and sound effects. Presentation aids can be three-dimensional objects, that means animal toys or people toys, like that. Visual aids can be a very powerful tool to enhance the impact of your presentation. So your presentation more effective when you use visual aids. So different types of visual aids. What are the visual aids? Different types. There are many different types of visual aids. The following advice will help you make the most of those most commonly used. First one is PowerPoint or equivalent. Microsoft PowerPoint is probably now the most commonly used form of visual aids. Used well, it can really help you in your presentation. So what are the main do's and don'ts in PowerPoint presentation? So first do's: use a big enough font in it, that means minimum 20 ppt. Next, keep the background simple, not shiny or thick colors. Use animations when appropriate. When it is needed only, you can use animations, pictures. make things visual. So it must be visual. First, next, don'ts. What should not do in PowerPoint presentation? Don't make it so small, the font. That means you cannot read it. Don't use a fuzzy background image. Don't put background image. Because of that, the words, sentence may not appear. But don't overdo animation. Don't put over animations. It gets distracting. Next, don't use endless slides, bulleted list that look the same. So don't use too many slides. Next one is white or blackboard. We have another second visual aids. White or blackboard can be very useful to help explain the sequence of ideas or routines, particularly in the sciences. Use them to clarify your title or to record your key points as you introduce your presentation. Next, paper handouts. Handouts are incredibly useful. That means papers, giving papers to the audience. Whatever you want to say, just already preparing them and giving the handouts to the audience. Use handouts if your information is too detailed to fit on the slide, or if you want your audience to have full record of your findings. Whatever you want to say may not possible to explain in the presentation. So it is better to give on paper complete details and distribute them. So consider the merits of passing around your handouts at the beginning, middle and end of the presentation. You can give them in the beginning or middle or end of the presentation. Given too early and they may prove distractions, but don't give too early. After starting the presentation, you can distribute them. Next, flip charts. Flip charts. A flip chart is a large pad of paper on a stand. It is a very useful and flexible way of recording information during your presentation. You can write it. You can even use prepared sheets for key points. Next, video or videos. Video gives you a chance to show stimulating visual information. Use videos to bring movement, pictures, and sound into your presentation. Always make sure that the clip is directly relevant to your content. Next, developing public speaking skills. Public speaking skills refer to the talent of effectively addressing an audience. So everybody is suffering, everybody feels shy and shivering when anybody wants him to speak in the public. So it is very important, public speaking skill. Whether it is in front of a group of people you already know or a crowd of complete strangers, your ability to communicate to them with clarity and confidence is known as your public speaking skills. Public speaking is the process or act of performing a speech to a live audience. Public speaking is commonly understood as formal, that is official. Face-to-face speaking of a single person to a group of listeners. Next, importance of public speaking. Why we should speak in public? What are the benefits of speaking in public? So good public speaking skills can have a huge impact on your career for the following reasons. One, demonstrates your knowledge. How much knowledge you have. If you speak, then only we came to know. If you don't speak, if you don't exhibit, we may not know how much knowledge you have. So you are always at your best when you can articulate your thoughts clearly and effectively. Public speaking skills help you do exactly that. Next important point is demonstrates your confidence. Are you confident or not? So this shows. It develops and demonstrates your confidence, whether you are interviewing for a job, whether you are participating in a interview, or hoping for a promotion. Your confidence is what will make you stand out among other candidates. This makes the difference between normal people and you, other people and you. Next, third one, helps you lead better. So, the higher you climb up the career ladder, the greater will be the number of people you shall have to lead. So, you have to be a team leader. You have to guide hundreds of people, thousands of people. So you have to explain the concept, you have to explain the thing, what they are going to do, what they have to do. As a result, that need for public speaking skills and the confidence pertinent to it also increases, making it one of the determining characteristics when considering someone for promotion. Next, ceremonial speaking. That means in marriages or in a death anniversary or birth anniversary or some on famous persons, regarding famous persons. Okay, ceremonial speaking. Most people will give some sort of ceremonial speech during their lifetime. That means Kasturba Gandhi, Mahatma Gandhi, Jyotiba Phule, when their birthday or death anniversary, we speak about them. These speeches make special occasions. These speeches mark special occasions. They are common at weddings, graduations, and funerals, as well as large birthday celebrations and office holiday parties. Next, fifth one, demonstrative speaking. Science demonstrations and role playing are types of demonstrative speaking. This type of public speaking requires being able to speak clearly and concisely to describe actions and to perform those actions while speaking. The idea behind demonstrative speaking is that the audience members leave with the knowledge about how to do something. Sixth one, informative speaking. With informative speaking, the speaker is trying simply to explain a concept to the audience members. College lectures, courses involve informative speaking, as do industry conferences and public officials sharing vital information. Next, persuasive skills. Persuasive means making them understand your concern and agreeing, making them agree whatever you say. Persuasive speaking tends to be the most easy. Politicians, lawyers, and clergy members use persuasive speaking. This type of speaking requires practicing voice inflections and nuances of language that will convince the audience members of the certain viewpoint. Okay, next main point is tips to develop public speaking skills. Then how to develop public speaking skills? What are the main points the speaker or the orator or any student should develop? If the student or a person or employee wants to speak in the public, he has to develop these things. He has to follow these tips. So, tips to develop public speaking skills. Nervousness is normal in public speaking. While you speak, nervousness is normal. Practice and practice. The most you practice, the nervousness will come down. Know your audience. What type of audience are they? If you know the audience, you can speak effectively. Your speech is about them, not you. You are going to give some information to the audience, not to yourself. So you have to speak according to their interest. So what are the interests of the audience? You have to know. Next, organize your material in the most effective manner to attain your purpose. So whatever the information you want to present, you have to organize it. You have to present it systematically. Next, watch for feedback and adapt to it. If anybody gives feedback, your speech is good, but these areas are not good. You have to develop this activity. Then you have to take the feedback and adapt it. You have to follow it. Next, let your personality come through. So whatever the personality, your honesty, your discipline, your punctuality, like that. Next, use humor, tell stories, and use effective language. Language must be effective, attractive. In your language, use humor, comedy, that means jokes, like that. Tell stories, interesting stories, moral stories. Use your voice and hands effectively. Voice and hands, you have to use both with coordination. Omit nervous gestures, so shaking gestures, shivering gestures, you have to keep them aside. Next, grab attention at the beginning and close with a dynamic end. So you have to attract the attention of the audience at the beginning and close your speech or your presentation with a dynamic end. Effective. Next, use audio visual aids wisely. Wisely means cleverly. At what time do they need? What time do they not need? Next, don't be afraid to fail. So don't think you will become failed. Definitely your speech will be utter flop. Don't think like that. Practice and practice. No other way. There is no short route. Next, record yourself on video. Before going to speech, just rehearse it. Record it in a video, using mobile phone. Next, practice with a friend or colleague. Give your speech presentation before a friend or a colleague and get feedback. Next, finally, know your environment. Whether the PowerPoint presentation is there, whether the hall is big or small, whether the blackboard is there or not, whether the furniture is sufficient or not, like that. So these are the things are involved in presentation skills. Okay, I hope you understood well. I recorded these sessions, two sessions. I will upload in YouTube and share the link in your WhatsApp group.